सो पॉलिनेशन एंड फर्टिलाइजेशन. व्हाट इज पॉलिनेशन? वी डिस्कस्ड इन अवर लास्ट क्लास, यू नो पॉलिनेशन इज व्हाट इट इज. अ बेसिकली इट इज द ट्रांसफर ऑफ द मेल गैमेट ऑफ द फ्लावर टू द फीमेल गैमेट. ओके, सो बेसिकली ट्रांसफर ऑफ योर पॉलन्स. ओके, पॉलन्स विच कंटेन्स द मेल गैमेट. ओके, टू द फीमेल पार्ट. ओके, फीमेल पार्ट इज व्हाट? स्टिग्मा. एट द टॉप ऑफ द स्टिग्मा विच इज स्टिकी. ओके, सो ट्रांसफर ऑफ पॉलन. ओके, फ्रॉम द मेल पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लावर टू द फीमेल पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लावर, दैट इज कॉल्ड पॉलिनेशन. राइट, आई थिंक दिस इज नोन टू एवरी वन.
यस मिस.
ओके, सो वॉट इज पॉलन ग्रेन? एनी वन कैन टेल वॉट इज पॉलन ग्रेन?
And the male gametes.
Pollen grains are not the male gametes, but they contain the male gametes. Okay, in the last chapter here also we will see how the fertilization is taking place. Okay,
means the anthers, I think they contain powdery thing, I think that is called pollen grain.
Very good. So we saw that anther was the male part, male reproductive part of the flower, right? Anther and stamen together, anther and stamen is known as what? Sorry, anther and filament. I already took the name stamen. Okay. Yeah.
Stamen.
Anther and filament is known as stamen, right? So anther is a bilobed structure, right? We saw in the last chapter that anther is a bilobed structure, right? And each lobe, you know, each lobe contains what? Two pollen sac, right? I showed you in the last diagram. Okay,
yes.
Anther contains pollen sacs, which is filled with, you know, pollen grains. Okay, pollen grains are powdery substances, right? So I can just show you. It will be just. So this much is not required actually. I wanted to show you this part. Basically, this is anther. Don't go in details. This is anther. Okay. This is filament. Anther is bilobed. From outside, you can see bilobed, and each lobe contains two pollen sac. So there is total of four pollen sac, in which pollen grains is filled. Pollen grain is filled in every sac. Okay, so this is the structure of anther. Is it clear?
Yes, miss.
Am I clearly audible? Connection is fine? Internet connection?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So, you have read that stamens of the flower are the male organs. Anther of the stamen produces powdery material, which is known as pollen, right? So, these are the powdery material, okay? It consists of particles which are known as pollen grains. So, each pollen grain contains nuclei that participate in reproduction. ठीक है, higher classes में we will see that you know what all things are there in the pollen grain, because when it goes and attaches to the female part, then what happens? There is a formation of pollen tube, which will go to the ovary of the male, female. Okay, so in that pollen tube, what will go? These nuclei, na? These nuclei which participate in reproduction, they will reach to the female gamete. Okay, so for initiating this process of formation of fruit and seeds, the first step is the pollen grains must reach the stigma. Okay, so fertilization ka first step kya hai for plants? Pollens must reach to the stigma. Okay, and this happens by the help of pollination. Okay, by the process, in the process of pollination. So the pollen of the same flower may fall on its stigma by itself. Okay, this is known as autogamy. Okay, what is this? Same flower is there. Okay, same flower will can have both male and female parts. Okay, if both male and female organs are there, okay, then the pollen can fall on the stigma itself. This is known as autogamy.
Okay? Yes, it's also called self-pollination.
Self-pollination can be of two types. Okay, self-pollination can be different flowers of the same plant. Okay, or same flower itself. Okay, here you can see the diagram here. Is it visible to everyone? So same flower will have both stamen and pistil, you know. So your pollen can go from the anther to the stigma of the same flower, this flower, for example, you know, I can see this flower. So this flower can pollinate itself, okay, which will be known as autogamy, or it can pollinate this other flower of the same plant. Ho sakta hai ki kya ho? Same flower mein maturity of the female part and male part may not take place at the same time. Okay, and any insect can sit on the pollen of this flower and then it will sit on the stigma of this flower. Okay, so then what will happen? This flower will pollinate another flower of the same plant. Okay, so same plant and different flowers, that is known as ketonogamy. Okay, ketonogamy. So this is another flower of the same plant. Okay, so understood the difference between autogamy and ketonogamy?
Yes, miss.
So these two types, both of these types will be known as self-pollination. Okay, both will be known as self-pollination. Okay, then the third category is the pollen of a flower of another plant of the same species, obviously. Because different species cannot. What is the definition of species?
Different species cannot. Even if they breed, they cannot produce fertile offspring.
Correct. So usually they cannot, interbreed, and even if they do, in certain cases, they do not produce fertile offspring. Okay. Fertility rate decreases up to zero or some percentage remains. So basically, in short, same species may hi pollination will result into the fertilization and formation of seeds. Okay. So second type, cross pollination, means the flower of one plant, okay, male of one plant flower is reaching to the stigma of the another flower, another plant. Okay, so this is known as what? This is known as allogamy. Okay, so this particular type of pollination is known as cross pollination. Okay, so this transfer can occur through wind, insects or other agents, and the term used for this transference is cross pollination. Okay, getono means neighbor, so you'll remember neighbor flower, like just same plant with dusra flower. So here the definition is given for the pollination, that is, it is the process of transference of pollen grains or transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma. Okay. So pollination must occur between plants of the same species. Okay, this is very important point जो मैंने आपको भी discuss किया. ठीक है. So pollination must occur between plants of the same species. Many different kinds of flowering plants may be growing in the same vicinity, right? For example, you know, orchard may have trees of mango, guava, okay, lychee, etc. Even some wild trees like neem, jamun, or sesame, okay. So they may also be growing, you know, in the same place. They can be neighbor, but obviously we don't find that mango will fertilize neem, right? Because pollination must occur between the plants of same species. Similarly, various crops may be growing in neighboring agricultural fields, wheat, mustard, pulses, vegetables, and so on. The wind may blow away the pollen from all such plants together, and thus what happens? The flowers of particular plant may receive all kind of pollen of its own kind as well as of others, right? So similarly, insects like bees and butterflies generally do not discriminate between plants and collect nectar from all kind of flowers. In the process, the insects are carrying different types of pollen on their bodies. Therefore, the stigma of the flower of any one particular plant receives pollen of its own species as well as of the other. But nature has so designed that only the pollen of the same species of plant will survive and grow further to continue the process for reproduction, and the rest of the species of pollen will fail to germinate and they will perish. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Okay, so here also we understand the definition of species.
Is there any process or something through which that stigma recognizes
There is pollen process. There is process that you will study in class 12th. Okay, there is a chemical interaction. Okay, there is a chemical interaction. Chemoreceptors will be there.
Miss, stigma releases some chemicals.
Yeah.
It's because our school teacher told that pollen grain sits on that stigma, it releases some kinds of chemicals through which means the stigma recognizes whether the pollen grain is of
the same species or yes. Okay, so there is a chemical interaction. There are chemical receptors. Okay, when you will go in details, so you will see there will be chemical receptors. How it will understand that the pollen is of our species or some different species, and then only it will recognize, and then it will allow it to form the pollen tube. Otherwise, it won't do any kind of interaction. Okay, so the interaction is basically chemical type. Okay, so details we don't need to know right now. That is a part of higher class. Okay, we'll study in higher classes. So kinds of pollination, there can be self pollination and cross pollination, which we saw in the diagram. Okay, so self pollination means what? The transfer of pollen from anther to the stigma of same flower or another flower of the same plant, that is autogamy and gametogamy. Pollination between flowers of the same plant is considered same self pollination on account of the common genetic character. Okay, so basically when the pollination is self, okay, then difference, you know, variation in the genetic makeup will be very less. Okay, so there won't be much variations. Okay, general qualities of the features of the of any one plant are the same in different flowers born on it. Okay, so agar hum genetic variations ki baat karenge, so genetic variations bahut kam aayenge self pollination mein, correct? In some rare case, okay, for example pansy, okay, some flowers growing close to the ground level do not open at all. Okay, so they remain closed. That's why it is known as cleistogamy. So the anthers and stigma lie close to each other, which mature at the same time, and self-pollination is assured. ठीक है, so cleistogamy क्या होती है? Cleistogamy का मतलब होता है, we are talking about those plants which has a closed flower. Closed flower in the sense their reproductive parts are not open for insects or any kind of pollinator, pollinating agents. Okay, so the flower is closed, the male and female parts, okay, they get mature at the same time, they pollinate each other and they produce seeds. Okay, there is no other option. They don't have option of ketonogamy. Okay, they're the only option is autogamy. Are you getting my point?
Yes, miss.
But sure, these are usually closed flowers.
So this is a kind in autogamy.
This is a kind of autogamy. Yes, someone else was asking.
Yes, miss.
Are you speaking something, Haji? Hadi, I'm not able to hear you.
Miss, can I?
Tell Shilita.
Miss, most of the I have seen some flowers which remain unbloomed during the daytime. Do they also use the same process for pollination, self pollination?
No. These plants which I am telling, they do not they do not open at all throughout their life. In those, these cleistogamy occurs. Okay, and then there are few plants which which will be closed at night, and then when daylight comes, it opens. So that is another phenomena in the flowers for certain purposes. So, but these cleistogamy condition that occurs only in the flowers which remains closed throughout. Okay, and they have a special feature. What is that? That is their anther and stigma. They are very close to each other, and both the parts get mature at the same time. That if it is not there, then this plant will disappear. It will not reproduce, right? Because self-pollination mein kya hota hai? Ketonogamy ka condition kyun aata hai? Basically, why? Because sometimes many of the plants are there in which both male and female parts are there, but both of them do not get mature at the same time. Maybe the male part gets mature first, and female gets matured, little in late. Okay, so the male parts, when it gets mature, okay, still it won't be able to fertilize the female part of the same flower. Okay, because of the lack of maturity in the female part. So it can mature the other flower or cross pollination. Matlab, can be in many things. Okay, so in such flowers, basically, जहाँ पे मेल और फीमेल पास मेच्योरिटी का जो टाइम होता है वो वेरी करता है, सो दे आल्सो डू नॉट अंडरगो ऑटोगेमी बिकॉज ऑफ दिस डिफरेंस इन मैच्योरेशन टाइम. ओके, एंड ऑब्वियसली गिटोनोगेमी उसमें तो होगा ही, इन द केस दैट वन फ्लावर इज ऑफ मेल टाइप एंड वन फ्लावर इज ऑफ द फीमेल टाइप, मतलब ओनली वन सेक्स इज प्रेजेंट इन अ फ्लावर. ओके, यू so in those cases also we'll find ketonogamy, and in the case which in the example which I told you, like even if both of them are present in the same flower, both male and female are present in the same flower, but if both are not getting matured at the same time, there is difference in the maturity of time, then also they will undergo ketonogamy. Am I clear to everyone?
Yes. Okay. So there can be a possibility that in the same plant, in two different flowers, in one flower the anther, that is the stamen may mature, and in the other flower the pistil may mature.
Yes, it is possible. It is possible. Maybe when stamen gets mature first, and then when slowly it gets its maturity goes down, and female parts get mature. ओके तो ऐसा होता है कि मेल पार्ट जब मेच्योर है किसी और फ्लावर का फीमेल पार्ट मेच्योर है सो गेटोनोगेमी कैन ओकर इवन क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन कैन ओकर ओके बट सेल्फ बट ऑटोगेमी इज नॉट वेरी मतलब नॉट श्योर ऑटोगेमी नहीं होता है मोस्टली ऐसे फ्लावर्स में ठीक है सो वेन कैन सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन अकर Self pollination can occur in bisexual flowers, in flowers having both male and female organs, or it can also occur in such unisexual flowers where both male and female flowers are born on the same plant. Okay, to ensure self pollination, it is necessary that the anther and stigma of a flower must mature at the same time. Okay, so basically from this point. इट कैन बी यू नो स्पेशली अगर किसी एक प्लांट में एक ही समय पे सारे मेल पार्ट मेच्योर हो रहे हैं और उसके बाद फीमेल पार्ट मेच्योर हो रहे हैं सो मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम उस केस में क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन होती है सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन यूजली अकर नहीं करती है राइट सो यहाँ पे टू इंश्योर सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन इट इज नेसेसरी दैट द एंथर एंड स्टिग्मा ऑफ अ फ्लावर मस्ट मेच्योर एट द सेम टाइम और इफ द फ्लावर्स आर यूनिसेक्सुअल and born on the same plant then they must also mature at the same time okay this concept is clear to everyone
yes miss.
Okay. I want to hear yes from all of you only I hear from 2-3 students Yashwant Rajiv I never hear from you all you also should interact more in the class right okay So, advantages and disadvantages of self-pollination. What are advantages and disadvantages of self-pollination? It is much surer in such bisexual flowers where stamens and carpels mature at the same time. Okay. So, this is the advantage of self-pollination first thing. Okay. जहाँ पे भी you know stamen और carpels एक समय पे mature हो रहे हैं So, self-pollination is very common. Okay. Then, parental characters are preserved. Very important point. Okay. From genetics point of view, it is very important. Parental characters are preserved. Okay. Parental characters are preserved. There is no wastage of pollen grains. Even a small quantity of pollen will be sufficient. Okay, so very less pollen is required for the self-pollination. The flower need not to be large and showy because it has to do self-pollination. It doesn't need any pollinating agent. Okay, so pollinating agent in the sense it's very close in very much proximity, a small like very slow air also is sufficient for transfer of pollen. So it need not to be very large and attractive and you know like that. Scent and nectars also are not usually there, you know, not be produced by flowers. Because why these things are not required? Because these particular characters are required by those flowers which need pollinating agents like insects to come attract, take their nectar and pick up the pollen and take it to the other flower okay so in that case actually flowers are designed in a way that they should be more attractive either through color or through scent you know some fragrance okay clear
miss so it's the second point again
second point parental characters are preserved why parental characters are preserved See, same plant is there, right? Same plant means whatever genes and chromosomes will be there. Okay, that will be same for the whole plant. It won't vary from one flower to the other flower of the same plant, right? So when they are being fertilized, so their crossing is happening. So in that crossing, you know, we have heard that during meiosis, certain characters they get mingled. Of the parents, right? Both male and female, some characters will mingle. So if the parents are from the same genetic background, okay, same plant, then the characters will be preserved. Like whatever will be the shape of the flower, color of the flower, variety of the flower, it won't have any difference, okay, in the next generation. Whatever will be produced will be of the exactly same type genetically also. Are you getting my point?
Yes, Miss, understood.
Okay. Yes, Miss.
No, ma'am, I can't able to understand. Please explain what you told.
See, what is meiosis? Tell me, Rajiv. What do you understand by normally, matlab fertilization mein kya hota hai? What is your understanding? Yes, tell. Can you hear me, Rajiv? Am I audible? I think this. Am I audible to others?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Yes,
Rajiv might be facing
some connectivity. Yes, I'm speaking something. Rajiv, can you hear? I can see your chat. You can reply in the chat if you can hear me. Can you hear me? Okay, I think there is some connectivity problem. Please reconnect, Rajiv, so that I can hear you. Okay, we will clarify your doubts. Please reconnect and then we will again take this point. So we'll move further. Others are clear with this point?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Okay.
Miss, can I tell you one thing? Miss,
mm-hmm.
Miss, if Raji means was not being able to hear your voice, Miss, then how he could say no, ma'am?
Probably he's not understanding, so he's replying like that. I'm not sure. If he can hear, then he will reply. Okay. So Rajiv, if you can hear, please reconnect because I am not able to hear your voice. Okay. Because to understand actually this question, you have to speak a little bit because then I will understand how much you have understood the basic concept of meiosis. Then only you will be able to understand preservation of genetic character. Okay. So all these points which we discussed till now, okay. So all these points are the advantages of the self-pollination. Okay. So all the above advantages mean great economy on the part of the plant. A lot of nutrient materials which would otherwise be used in the production of pollen, nectar, scent, and large petals is saved. Disadvantages. What are the disadvantages? Weakening of the variety. It is just opposite of the point which I marked below. Okay. Weakening of the variety. That means opposite of preserving the parental characters. That means, what does it mean? It means that basically, I am more similar to my brothers and sisters in genetic makeup than my cousin brothers and sisters, right? Because we are born to the same parents, right? And similarly, we'll be more different from, like our second cousins, right? So why is it so? Because from the same parent, and especially when we are talking about the plants, it is the same plant. Not even two parents. Okay. So it is the same plant and same flower. If it is the same flower of the plant, you know. So then what will happen? The characters will be same. Okay, when the characters are same, then there won't be any variation. Like आप लोगों को बोलते हैं ना लोग कि you know आपकी आंखें बिल्कुल आपके father की तरह हैं, या you look more similar to your mother, or you look more similar to your father, right? So that similarity is basically we are more closer genetically to our parents, right? Similarly, when we have cross between the same flower of the plant, you know, character of the parents will remain as such, okay? But variations बहुत कम होंगी. So that means what? Continued self-pollination, generation after generation, will lead to what? Weakening of the variety. I mean, variations नहीं होंगी. आपको बहुत सारे जैसे एक ही flower की बहुत varieties आपको दिख जाती हैं, ठीक है? एक ही species की बहुत सारी varieties आपको दिखती हैं, right? So वो varieties आपको नहीं दिखेंगी because cross-pollination नहीं हो रहा है. Different varieties आपस में cross करके नया product नहीं बना रहे हैं. इसलिए what we will see weakening of the varieties or the species. Okay, the seeds produced through it are poor in quality and give rise to less vigorous offsprings. Many of times self-pollination for a very long time means many of the generations, if only self-pollination is occurring, then fertilization efficiency also decreases, you know. And in class 12th we will see this, you know, even in humans when we'll see plants may aap samajh nahi paoge, but humans may when we'll study, that's why you know marriage in the same progeny is restricted, you know, marriage between the same progeny is restricted. Why? From the cultural point of view, because that creates certain problems, okay, in the coming generations. Okay, that's why same brothers and sisters, they're not, you know, they should not marry. Even the cousin, very close cousins, should not marry, because they will acclimatize certain genetic disorders. We will study in class 12. However, in certain dynasty, you know, it was a system just for keeping the line very pure. So their purity actually meant genetic purity and genetic characters should remain pure, and they used to marriage in the same ancestral line. Okay, so that feature is basically what? To preserve the genetic character of the parents. But actually disadvantages is what? Basically whatever next generation comes, okay, they are usually poor in quality. Even in humans, they will acclimatize certain diseases. Okay, so weakening of the variety, there won't be variations, much variations when we are talking about plants. Is this point clear to everyone?
But how the quality is becoming poor? How the quality is becoming poor?
Yeah, quality becomes poor because as you have seen cross, जैसे आपको देसी टमाटर होते हैं, ठीक है, और बहुत सारे ऐसे प्लांट्स होते हैं जो कि सिर्फ आप उनको नॉर्मली मतलब ऐसे खाते हो. मैं देसी टमाटर तो नहीं बोल सकती बिकॉज इट इज नॉट जस्ट क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन, इट इज ट्रांसजेनिक टाइप्स. बट नॉर्मली जो सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन में होंगे उनमें क्या होता है, उसमें फर्टिलिटी रेट ऑल्सो लिटिल बिट डिक्रीजेस, एंड क्वालिटी, यू नो, क्वालिटी वाइज ऑल्सो दे डिक्रीज, जैसे कि न्यूट्रिशनल क्वालिटी जो होती है प्रोडक्ट की, ठीक है, दैट ऑल्सो इज अफेक्टेड वेन यू नो सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन इज फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम. ओके, सो am I making some sense? कुछ क्लियर हो रहा है आपका?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
सबको समझ में आ रहा है कि नहीं?
Yes, miss.
ठीक है. Okay. So next point is the weaker or defective characters of the variety cannot be एलिमिनेटेड. ठीक है, जो भी आपकी वैरायटी है, जो भी आपकी ब्रीड है, उसमें जो उसके जेनेटिक प्रॉब्लम्स होंगे दे विल रिमेन एज सच, राइट? क्योंकि हम उसको किसी और वैरायटी के साथ क्रॉस करा ही नहीं रहे हैं, जिससे यू नो जब हम क्रॉस करते हैं तो क्या होता है, क्रॉस करने से होता है कि जैसे मान लो 10 कैरेक्टर्स मदर के पास है, 10 कैरेक्टर्स फादर के पास है, तो चाइल्ड विल हैव इन जनरल 5 कैरेक्टर्स फ्रॉम मदर एंड 5 फ्रॉम फादर, राइट? सो रेस्ट 4 और 5 ऑफ बोथ ऑफ देम विल बी लॉस्ट एट द सेम टाइम. यू नो द चाइल्ड विल हैव सम न्यू कैरेक्टर्स और मिक्स ऑफ टू, राइट? सो इफ बोथ parents, like in the self-pollination, if both male and female, they have all the same characters, 10 and 10 characters are exactly same in both of them because they are from the same plant. So the child will have all 10 characters. Nothing will be lost, nothing will be gained. Right? So no new variety. At the same time, if 10 of the qualities have something which is a defective character, you know, say some character is like bahut jaldi, you know, yellowing, मतलब yellowing हो जाती है, या फिर कुछ बहुत जल्दी, you know, ripening बहुत ज़्यादा जल्दी हो जाती है, ठीक है? या फिर कुछ भी ऐसा हो सकता है कि more prone to certain disease or certain insects, ठीक है? So those things also will remain as such. So basically, defective characters or weaker aspects, okay, that cannot be eliminated in self-pollination. Okay? Is this point clear?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Yes. The third is, it does not yield new varieties. ये तो हमने देख ही लिया, क्योंकि self-pollination है, new variety won't be there. ठीक है? So genetic traits of the same plant with no change and without any intermixing are passed on to the next generation. Thus, there is little chance for improvement in the next generation. Okay? So there is no chance of improvement. So these are the disadvantages of self-pollination. Okay? So self-pollination is clear to everyone?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Jyoti, are you getting the points?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next is your cross-pollination. Okay? So cross-pollination is transfer of pollen from anther of flower of one plant to the stigma of a flower of another plant of the same species. ये लिखना बहुत जरूरी है, ठीक है? जब भी आप ये definition लिखते हो, please write of the same species. Okay? That completes the whole definition. So it too has advantages and disadvantages. Let's see the advantages first. The offspring are more healthier. Why so? Because they are selected by the environment. The seeds produced are abundant and viable. Okay. New varieties may be produced by cross pollination. Okay. So new varieties will be produced. Okay. So these are the advantages. What are disadvantages? The pollination is not always certain. Okay. Because obviously pollinating agent is required. They will sit whether they have taken the pollen or not properly. So all these things are there. So the pollination is not always certain because some pollinating agent is always needed, which may or may not be available at the proper time. Second thing, the pollen has to be produced in large quantity. Okay, why so? Because jab nectar le raha hai pollinating agent, for example, insect, mostly insects ke through hota hai. Sometimes water, sometimes air. So mostly insects. So what happens? It will stick to their all body parts. Then when it sits on stigma and it is going to take nectar not only from one flower, obviously, right? It will take the nectar from different flowers. So obviously it will take pollen of many flowers. Now if it is sitting on any other flower, so it will, you know, leave pollens of different flowers. So basically pollen has to be, you know, more, you know, large in quantity so that much of it should stick so that ultimately when it reaches to the female part, okay, of the flower, of any flower, So some of the, you know, pollen should remain there, you know, should be attached on the surface of the insect or the pollinator, okay, and should reach the female part. Okay, so basically it should be large quantity, and because it is large in quantity, so lots of wastage happens, right? Lots of pollen gets wasted during the pollination process. Okay, the process is uneconomical for the plant. Why uneconomical for the plant? Can anyone tell why uneconomical? What is the meaning of this term here? Shujita, can you tell?
This means that the flowers cannot be used for, I think, economical activities.
Anyone else? Anish, can you tell?
Miss, can I tell?
Wait, go on. Let others also try. Hadi? Are you having any idea? क्या बोल रहे हो हादी?
Don't know.
Okay. Anushita, yes.
The flowers have to be large and have to produce nectars to attract the insects. That's why.
So that is already written here. You can see. But I'm asking you how it is uneconomical for plant.
Can I just try?
Yes, here.
So much of wastage of pollen grains, therefore.
Okay. Yes, Pawan.
Miss, can I?
Shujita, bolo.
Miss, because these are uneconomical because by this way they are not able to attract any agents.
No.
No, they are already attracting the insects.
They are attracting through these things, na? Yes, Pawan, tell.
So I think that uneconomical for plant means that they need more energy than the plants that are carrying out self pollination to do all these chemical reactions to produce the flowers, means to produce colorful flowers, means attractive flowers, and to produce nectar from the nectaries. They need more energy to just perform these reactions. So that is why, yeah, that is not uneconomical.
Very good. So basically, uneconomical means economical kab hota hai? Economical ka matlab hota hai ki jab maine kuch paisa kharcha kiya, I am getting equal benefit or more benefit or not. Right?
If I'm giving short, profitable.
Yeah. So basically, economical means something profitable, and even you are not profitable, but basically you should not undergo any loss. Okay. So here basically the purpose is what? Purpose is to fertilize. Fertilization ke liye, what the flower is doing, what the plant is doing, very less of pollen, no energy in making the flower very attractive, producing nectar, and many such strategies are not required. Right? So very less energy investment and fertilization is happening. Fertilization is the most important part. Right? So what is happening here also? Lots of energy is being input. Okay. Lots of energy is going into what? Into production of large quantity of this, you know, pollen. Then to make the flower very large so that all the pollinators can come and sit. It should be colorful. It should be scented so that pollinating agents should get attracted. Right? So lots of energy is being, wasted. Not wasted in that way, but it's required for those plants which undergo cross-pollination for the purpose of fertilization, because fertilization is the most important aspect of any species, any organism. Okay, so therefore cross pollination is uneconomical for the plant. Is it clear for everyone?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss. Yes.
Okay. So the difference between self-pollination and cross-pollination are given in the table. You can go through the table. So nature favors cross-pollination. Why? Even if it is energy requiring process, uneconomical process, why nature favors cross-pollination? So the vast majority of flowering plants are cross-pollinated. Some of the various devices, okay, or the conditions which favor cross-pollination are given here. Okay, so unisexuality, okay, so flowers are there which are, you know, like unisexual, that means either male or female, and they may be born on the separate plants also. Okay, in this way cross-pollination is the only possibility. Iske examples aate hain, palm and papaya. They are unisexual and the male and female, they are born on the separate plants. So they have only option of cross-fertilization. They do not have option of self-fertilization. Then papaya usually has separate male and female trees, but less frequently there may also be a hermaphroditous term. Hermaphrodite means bearing both the sexes in the same organism. Okay, tree bearing both kind of flowers. So in cucumber, the male and female flowers may be born on the same plant. Okay. So basically unisexuality can be one condition for favoring cross-pollination. Second is your dichogamy. What is dichogamy? Dichogamy means different timings of maturation of androecium and gynoecium. Different timings of maturation of androecium and gynoecium. In many bisexual flowers, the anthers and stigma of the same flower mature at different times, which I already told. ठीक है, आपको ये टर्म दिया है यहाँ पे, सो यू कैन रिमेम्बर प्रोटो एंड्री एंड प्रोटोगेमी. ठीक है, सो एंड्री इज एंड्रोशियम, गाइनी इज गाइनोशियम. ओके, सो एंड्रोशियम इज द मेल पार्ट, गाइनोशियम इज द फीमेल पार्ट. सो व्हेन यू नो इन सम प्लांट्स एंटर ऑफ द फ्लावर मैच्योर्स अर्लियर. ठीक है, व्हेन एंड्रोशियम गेट्स मैच्योर्ड फर्स्ट, it is proto ya protandry, and when gynoecium matures first, then it is protogyny. Okay, so these are the terminologies used for different maturity period of androecium and gynoecium. Okay, if the male part, that is androecium, gets matured first, then the stigma, then it is protandry. If the stigma of the flower matures earlier than the anthers, that means gynoecium gets matured, then it is protogyny. Okay, examples aap yaad rakh sakte ho. These are examples: bindi, sweet pea, salvinia, sunflower. They are protoandry. And custard apple, peepal, they are protogyny. So because of this condition also, they undergo cross pollination. So in either case, cross pollination is the only possibility. Then self sterility. ठीक है, अभी जैसे मैंने बताया था आपको, यहाँ पे maturity period में अगर बहुत ज्यादा time interval होता है, ठीक है, then there is no option but only cross pollination, जो कि maximum of the examples जो दिया हुआ है. In those cases, that occurs. So third is self-sterility. Self-sterility kya hoti hai? Basically, is condition mein, you know, if the stigma receives pollen from anthers of the same flower, ठीक है, the pollen fails to undergo further growth. मतलब self pollen लेने से सेल्फ पॉलन के लिए द फ्लावर इज स्टेराइल इन शॉर्ट. ओके, फॉर द सेल्फ पॉलन द प्लांट इज स्टेराइल. ओके, इट कैन नॉट रिसीव द पॉलन फ्रॉम द सेम फ्लावर. ठीक है, द पॉलन फेल्स टू अंडरगो फर्दर ग्रोथ. इन सच केसेस ओनली द पॉलन फ्रॉम अनदर प्लांट ऑफ द सेम स्पीशीज कैन इफेक्टिवली कंप्लीट द प्रोसेस ऑफ सेटिंग ऑफ द सीड्स. आई मीन फर्टिलाइजेशन, इसको हम बोलते हैं यहाँ पे जो हमने डिड वी डिस्कस रे फ्लोरेट्स ऑफ सनफ्लावर.
यस मिस.
सो देयर इट इज वेरी क्लियर कि हाउ रे फ्लोरेट्स ऑफ सनफ्लावर में क्या होता है. यू नो वन इज नॉट हैविंग द यू नो थिंग्स यू नो सेक्स पार्ट्स और दे आर स्टराइल. ओके सो इन दैट केस क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन इज द ओनली ऑप्शन. ओके यस समवन वाज आस्किंग समथिंग. इज देयर एनी डाउट एनीवन?
कैन यू अगेन एक्सप्लेन
सेल्फ स्टेरिलिटी?
नो.
ओके सेल्फ स्टेरिलिटी का मतलब है कि सेम फ्लावर का जो पॉलन है, ओके सेम फ्लावर का जो पॉलन है व्हेन इट फॉल्स ऑन स्टिग्मा, ओके सो इट डज नॉट जर्मिनेट. पॉलन स्टिग्मा पे फॉल करने के बाद भी उसमें कोई फर्दर ग्रोथ नहीं होती है. दैट मीन स्टराइल मतलब क्या होता है? स्टराइल मतलब फर्टिलिटी लॉस. लेकिन फ्लावर की फर्टिलिटी लॉस किसके लिए? ओनली फॉर द सेल्फ पॉलन. लेकिन अगर दूसरे प्लांट का पॉलन आता है, दूसरे मतलब फ्लावर जो कि दूसरे प्लांट पे है, ठीक है, फ्रॉम द सेम स्पीशीज ऑब्वियसली, इफ द पॉलन कम्स फ्रॉम एनी अदर फ्लावर, ओके देन इट कैन रिसीव इट. सो स्टिग्मा कैन रिसीव पॉलन फ्रॉम अदर फ्लावर एंड ग्रो टू द फर्टिलाइजेशन, कंप्लीट द फर्टिलाइजेशन. हाउएवर in case of the pollen of the same flower, it is sterile, it acts sterile. Okay, is it clear?
Yes miss.
Yes ma'am.
Okay, here it is clear to you properly?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so next is what? Next is your herpogamy. Herpogamy means mechanical barriers. ठीक है? So basically क्या होता है? कुछ flowers में, you know, pollen of the flower cannot reach to the stigma of the same flower due to certain mechanical barriers. ठीक है? Example के लिए क्या दिया हुआ है? A hood covering the stigma acts as a mechanical barrier in pansy flower. ठीक है, hood covering the stigma, ठीक है, that acts as a mechanical barrier. ठीक है, iris. So these are examples जहां पे male और female of for the same plant, ठीक है, there is a mechanical barrier. Then fifth point is heterostyly. Heterostyly क्या है? In such flowers, the stigma and anther grow at different heights. Okay, this is the different in the position. This is the mechanical barrier, like covering something like that. And this is what? This is their height difference, position difference. Okay, so यहाँ पे क्या होता है? Anther grows at different heights, which does not favor self-pollination. जैसे कि primrose. ठीक है, प्रिमरोस, ऑक्सालिस, दीज आर एग्जांपल्स ऑफ हेटरोस्टाइली. ठीक है, इज इट क्लियर?
यस मिस.
एनी डाउट एनीवन? No doubt. Should we proceed?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Okay. So further, what are the agents of cross-pollination? Okay. So the two commonest agents of cross-pollination are insects and wind. But some flowers are also pollinated by certain animals and birds, like squirrels, bats, etc. or even by water in case of some aquatic plants. Okay, so the common pollination agent are insects and wind. So let's see one by one. So insect pollination, we call it entomophilus. Okay, entomophilus, that is what? Flowers which get pollinated by through insects. Okay, then iska kya kya characters hai. हर एक टाइप ऑफ पॉलिनेशन का एक डिफरेंट कैरेक्टर होगा. मतलब ऑब्वियसली किसको अट्रैक्ट करना है. सो फ्लावर्स आर डिजाइंड इन दैट वे कि किस चीज को अट्रैक्ट करना है. अगर इंसेक्ट्स को अट्रैक्ट करना है तो फ्लावर्स के पास क्या क्या चीजें होनी चाहिए. फ्लावर शुड बी लार्ज सो वेयर दे कैन एक्चुअली सिट. ठीक है, दे कैन सी फ्रॉम फार लाइक दैट. देन दे शुड बी कलर्ड, ब्राइटली कलर्ड. ठीक है, और they should emit scent. ठीक है, कुछ फ्लावर्स होते हैं जो ब्राइटली कलर्ड नहीं होते, जो यूजली रात को ब्लूम करते हैं या लो डे लाइट में ब्लूम करते हैं, बट दे आर वेरी सेंटेड. जैसे आपको पता होगा राइट, जैसे मोगरा एंड पारिजात. सो मेनी फ्लावर्स आर देयर विच आर नॉट वेरी कलरफुल. दे आर वाइट इन कलर बट दे हैव वेरी फ्रेग्रेंट स्मेल. राइट, सो दे अट्रैक्ट इधर बाई लाइट, बाई कलर, ब्राइट कलर, और they attract by fragrance. They also produce nectar. Okay, nectar is one important thing. Why? For nectar actually they sit, the insects will sit to collect this nectar. Okay, then another important thing, ye aapko higher classes mein bhi ye sare points rahenge. So pollen grains ki ek particular feature hoti hai for insect pollination. Pollen grains are sticky or spiny. Okay, so that they can be carried by the insects easily. Okay, then stigma is also sticky. Aise flowers ka stigma bhi sticky hota hai. Why? So that when insect is sitting back on any stigma, the pollen should stick on the stigma. Okay, then flowers tend to be in clusters. ठीक है, to make them conspicuous. Conspicuous means visible, easily visible. Okay, so flowers tend to be in clusters. Okay, like dahlia. So that insects can see them easily. So this is the clusters mein kab hona chahiye, jab flowers bahut chote hote hain kuch. Okay, so in that case. So this is your insects, that is entomophilus. Then coming to wind pollination, wind pollinated flowers हम क्या बोलते हैं, विंड पॉलिनेशन को एनिमोफाइलस. एनिमोफाइलस, एनिमो मींस विंड, फाइल मींस एफिनिटी. ओके, सो दीस फ्लावर्स विल पजेस व्हाट ऑल थिंग्स. दे विल बी स्मॉल, राइट, दे आर यूजुअली नॉट ब्राइटली कलर्ड क्योंकि उनको इंसेक्ट्स को नहीं लेना है. राइट, तो इनका कलर नहीं होता है, इनके पास सेंट नहीं होती है. ठीक है, दे वोंट हैव फ्रेग्रेंस. ओके, the stamens are long and hang out. Ye important hai, stamens long honge and they'll be hang out, means so that wind se easily wo blow kar sake. Matlab wo easily flexible hote hain aur easily unka pollen bahar ki taraf aa sake due to wind. Theek hai, then inke paas kya hote hain, anthers jo hote hain. Anthers should not be sticky. You know, like pollen should not be sticky. Anthers should be large and loosely मतलब attached to the flower. ठीक है, so anthers को जैसे ही wind blow करती है तो anthers should be उसका जो pollen sac है वो easily burst करना चाहिए, easily open होना चाहिए और pollen release होने चाहिए. ठीक है, pollen obviously बहुत large quantity में रहते हैं क्योंकि आपको एयर के थ्रू जाना है. मेनी ऑफ द पॉलन विल गेट लॉस्ट इन बिटवीन. करेक्ट, देन पॉलन्स का जो कैरेक्टर है, पॉलन्स क्या होने चाहिए. दे शुड बी लाइट, ड्राई एंड स्मूथ. दे शुड बी लाइट, ड्राई एंड स्मूथ सो दैट दे कैन बी इजिली कैरीड अवे बाय द विंड. ठीक है, यहाँ पे एक इंपॉर्टेंट आता है, स्टिग्मा जो होते हैं, दे आर फेदरी एंड हैंग आउट. ठीक है, फेदरी स्टिग्मा Why feathering? To collect these pollen, which are very small particles. To collect them, the stigma are feathery, and they are also hang out. ठीक है? So to trap the pollen grains. Is it clear?
Yes, miss.
Okay.
Yes, miss, ma'am.
Then next is your water pollination. Water is hydrophilous, means affinity. So hydrophilous are the water pollinated flowers. ठीक है, इनके क्या कैरेक्टर होना चाहिए? ये वाटर में हो रहे हैं तो इनको भी पॉलिन, तो जब भी क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन बोल रहे हैं तो लार्ज नंबर तो बाय डिफॉल्ट होना चाहिए बच्चों, राइट? देन यहाँ पे क्या होने, दे हैव अ स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी ऑलमोस्ट इक्वल टू दैट ऑफ वाटर. ये इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर होता है यहाँ पे. दे हैव अ स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी ऑलमोस्ट इक्वल टू दैट ऑफ वाटर. ठीक है, सो दैट दे रिमेन फ्लोटिंग. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि ये, जैसे कि ये एग्जाम्पल आपका वेलिसन एरिया का दिया हुआ है यहाँ पे. सो यू कैन सी, राइट? सो यहाँ पे जब इनके एंथर्स हैं, पॉलन्स हैं, तो उनको फ्लोट करना चाहिए सो दैट इनका फ्लावर भी, जो रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट होता है, वो सरफेस तक आता है. ये भी एक इनके अंदर कैरेक्टर होती है. तो ये फ्लोट करना चाहिए. अगर ये फ्लोट नहीं करेंगे, इनकी स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी मतलब ऐसी हो कि ये सिंक कर जाए, then what will happen? Then fertilization won't take place, right? So basically, what happens in some special cases? ठीक है, Vallisneria का थोड़ा example अलग है, but mostly they have to float and they have to reach to the female part. ठीक है, so Vallisneria में क्या होता है, special cases, male flowers are such that they float on the surface of water till they meet female flowers. ठीक है, and ये जैसे कि Vallisneria में होता है, you can see here. ठीक है, यहाँ पे क्या होता है, नीचे ये जो male flowers होते हैं, इसमें से जो flower का portion होता है, ये mature होने के बाद निकल करके ऊपर float करने लगता है, और ये float करते करते female part के पास पहुँचता है, पूरा male flower itself, and then it gets fertilized. Okay, so this happens in the Vallisneria. क्योंकि इसमें male part, male plant अलग होता है, female plant अलग होता है. ठीक है, some flowers are pollinated by birds. ठीक है, उनको हम बोलते हैं ornithophile. ठीक है, इसके भी examples दिए हैं. ठीक है, इसके अलावा और भी चीजें, elephants के through अगर करता है. ठीक है, एक होता है जैसे animals के through. इसमें भी अगर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स, लाइक एलिफोफाइली, दैट इज एलिफेंट्स. ठीक है, सो एलिफेंट्स के थ्रू किसमें होता है, रेफ्लेशिया, हुज फ्लावर्स आर व्हाट, हुज फ्लावर्स आर वेरी लार्ज एंड आर फाउंड एट ग्राउंड लेवल. द पॉलन ग्रेन्स ऑफ वन फ्लावर गेट्स अटैच्ड टू द फीट ऑफ एलिफेंट्स एंड मे बी कैरीड टू द स्टिग्मा ऑफ अनदर फ्लावर व्हेन ट्रैम्पल्ड बाय दोज फीट. तो दिस इज अनदर, दिस इज अ स्पेशल टाइप. ये इतना नहीं पूछा जाता है, बट जस्ट बिकॉज इट्स गिवन इन योर बुक यू कैन रिमेम्बर. ओके, सो द थ्री मेन इंपॉर्टेंट आर व्हाट, एंटोमोफिली बाय इंसेक्ट्स, एनिमोफिली ओके बाय योर विंड, एंड देन हाइड्रोफाइली बाय वाटर. ये तीन टाइप ऑफ पॉलिनेशन का यू शुड नो द कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ द प्लांट. क्या क्या कैरेक्टर्स होने चाहिए फॉर दीज थ्री टाइप ऑफ पॉलिनेशन. Okay, is it clear to everyone?
Yes, miss. Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt in pollination? Okay, so let's go further. Artificial pollination. What is artificial pollination? So artificial pollination hota hai when actually हम बीच में आ जाते हैं, नो, when man himself transfers pollen to the stigma, तो उसको हम बोलते हैं artificial. जो भी naturally नहीं हो रहा है वो artificial होगा. तो artificial मतलब अपना दिमाग लगा के जब हम pollination कराते हैं, obviously animals भी करा रहे हैं, पर animals से जो pollination हो रही है वो उसको हम natural बोल रहे हैं, क्योंकि वो अपने फायदे के लिए नहीं कर रहे हैं. So only human beings do that, okay? So all artificial type of things, whatever you'll read in science, will be done by humans. Okay, so this is artificial pollination when man, does this transfer of pollen to stigma. So in the ancient civilization of Babylonia, it was a common practice to sprinkle male flower of palm on the female flower. Of course, at that time, they neither knew the sexuality of palm flowers nor anything about pollination, but this was a practice to get the new plants, to get the seeds, right? So in modern times, artificial pollination is also called as artificial crossing. It is a standard practice adopted by plant breeders and scientists in their efforts to evolve new varieties. They remove the anthers in young flowers and cover these flowers with plastic bags. ये word आप आगे चल के genetics का जो study किया था उसमें भी पढ़ेंगे Mendel's character कि how he crossed between two plants and checked the how genetics work for plants. Okay, so there was a scientist called as Mendel. So he did this particular thing. So usually what they do, they remove the anther, okay, from the young flowers. Is particular process ko bolte hain emasculation, okay, and cover these flower with plastic bags. Theek hai, so isme kya hoga jab aap cover kar doge uska anther hata ke,
miss, anthers won't come, means they will not be able to reach the stigma.
Yeah, so stigma will remain, sorry, that pollinates. And there is no self pollination, wo clear hoga. And then when the female part gets mature, they will pollinate such flower with the pollen from the desired variety. Okay, so it is very sure shot ki aap kaun si variety se kisko pollinate kar rahe hain, and then you study on it basically. Or sometimes it is for study and sometimes it is for producing a good variety of breeds, flowers or crops, it can be anything. Okay, so some examples of pollination, let's see few examples of pollination. So insect pollinated sweet pea. Okay, the insect such as the bee alight on the conspicuous corolla. The bee thrusts its long tongue in search of nectar. In the struggle, the wing petals of the flower are depressed, and the wing petals along with the needle petal are forced down, and the stamens and stigma touch the underside of the body of the insect. If this insect has already visited another flower, it may have some pollen sticking on it, on its body. The pollen is now transferred to the stigma of this new flower. Okay, and thus fertilization will take place. Okay, pollination will take place. Okay, so when the insect flies away, it may in return carry some pollen of this flower to other similar flower. However, if cross pollination does not take place, there is every chance of self pollination in this case, since both the stamen and carpels are enclosed within the needle and are more or less at the same level. तो हम जब स्वीट पी की बात करते हैं तो स्वीट पी में बोथ यू नो मेल एंड फीमेल पार्ट आर देयर विद इन. ओके, एंड नो मैकेनिकल बैरियर, नो पोजिशनल बैरियर्स. सो इट इज यू नो देयर इज पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन एज वेल एज क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन. ओके, बाय द हेल्प ऑफ इंसेक्ट. ओके, तो स्वीट पी में पॉलिनेशन कैसे होता है, बाय इंसेक्ट. नाउ कमिंग टू द विंड पॉलिनेटेड मेज. अभी आपको एक एक एग्जाम्पल याद रहेगा. यहाँ स्वीट पी में इंसेक्ट्स के थ्रू हो रहा है, विंड के थ्रू किस में होता है, मेज में होता है. आपने देखा है मेज का खेत, देखा होगा आप लोगों ने, लाइक फील्ड्स एटलीस्ट इन टीवी. सो पॉलिनेशन इज ब्रॉट अबाउट बाई विंड. ओके, सो सेम थिंग एज द विंड ब्लोज. तो आप देख रहे हो ये मेल इनफ्लोरेसेंस है, मेल फ्लावर है, यू नो. सो this is the position hangout jo bol rahe the na, hangout position mein. So here what will happen, as the wind blows, the pollen from outwardly hanging anther is blown away easily because the anthers are loosely attached to filament. See, here we are seeing the characters which we studied. So to the filament that the slightest wind will take shake them. The pollen blown away the away by the wind may fall on the feathery stigma of the female flower, and which have a large surface for this purpose. And you know, as it reaches, you know, it will help in pollination. The male flower mature earlier than female ones, so self-pollination is very rare here. So cross-pollination is the only possible way. So two examples are given to you. One is a sweet pea, another is maize, and that's it. So only two examples are given. Okay, so both the examples you can read, and if it is asked, you can write, you know, in 5 marks question. If you know, entomophily is given, then you should write the characters, and you can explain this example also very short, or at least write the example. Okay, so we have 15 more minutes. Are you all saturated?
Yes.
Who said yes? Who said yes? You can be honest. Okay, so no, it's
better we will heat ourselves to increase our saturity.
Okay, no need to heat yourself, remain cool. Okay, and so let's stop it here. Maybe in the next class we'll take the fertilization part in details. Okay, because it will take some more time and we have only 15 minutes more. So let's stop it here, and tell me what did you understand and what is your doubt. Everyone has to speak. Jyoti, this was your first class. Did you understand properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what did you understand? Tell me a few points.